So, good morning. We are going to learn how to do slope triangles. And on slope triangles, you will have a line, and all we do is we want to pay attention to that line. All the other information on that is confusing, but it's there to help us calculate slope. Because slope says it's a constant rate of change. But if I have 3 over 2, which means 3 up, 2 right, I can also go 6 up, 4 right, and I'll still land on the line because of this and this being fractions that when you simplify them, they're equal. And this is what it's going to demonstrate. So if it says find the slope of JL. So if I'm doing the slope of JL, I'm going to rise or run, and I typically fall. If it's a negative line, then I fall, and it's 1, 2, 3, 4. So that would be 4. And then 1, 2, 3, and that would be 3. Okay, so the slope of JL is 4/3. If you do the slope of MP, you're going from this point here and you're going 12, and then over here which is 9, and so it would be 12/9. But if you simplify 12/9, it's still 4/3. And so your slopes are the same. So this is called using similar triangles to calculate slope. We're gonna do another example. And so the line that you are looking at is this line right here. Notice that the line has negative slope. And I'm going from here to here, which is my fall. And my fall is 4 spots. And my run is 3. And then if I use this triangle right here, my fall is, let's see if I can do that a little bit neater. My fall is here, which is 8, and my run is 6. So 4/3 and 8/6, but that's simplified to 4/3. So the slope of this, of the line right here is 4/3. Make sure we put our negative sign. Make sure we have -4/3 and negative because we fell. Let's do some more.
Good morning, Warhawk.
Here, same thing. We are going to do.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America. And to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And now the Texas Pledge. Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to thee, Texas, one state under God, one and indivisible. Please remain standing for the moment of silence. Thank you. You may be seated. Make today the greatest day you've ever had. And remember, you belong here.
So when you video, you do sometimes get background noise, but that's okay. That was good background noise. Okay, so we're finding the slope of that line. We're using slope triangles, and my slope triangle is, my line is negative, so I have to remember that it's going to be a negative slope. So find the slope of DF, and that is rise to, run for. So that's 2/4, but that's a negative, and that's simplified to -1/2. If I'm going to go here, this is 6, and this is 2. And this one is 9. So I now have to figure out what I did wrong because 6/9 is not -1/2. So let's see. Oh, I miscounted. So I know that I miscounted. So we come up here and then that is 3. And then that's -6/9, which is -2/3. And let me fix this one. And so the concept is when you are doing slope triangles, that anywhere that you use your slope triangles, it should be the same value. So when I did it and I didn't get the same value, I knew that I needed to go back and check my work. You're gonna have a couple of questions on slope triangles and a quiz to accomplish today. If you have any questions, please attend office hours. Thank you.